Hello students, hope all of you are good. Let's continue with the same chapter, that is chapter number 11, ecosystem. So now we'll start with food web. The number of interconnected food chains are known as food web. जो भी ये food chains होती हैं ये interconnected होती हैं. Like for example, I'm showing you with this small example. Suppose grass can be eaten by rabbit, it can be eaten by deer as well. And this rabbit can be eaten by either lion or it can be eaten by wolf. Same deer can be eaten by either lion or it can be eaten by wolf. And this wolf can be eaten by lion. So you can see these food chain, a number of food chains are interconnected. This is known as food web. If suppose the population kisi karan se kya hoga, if due to any sort of reason this deer it become extinct, ye kya ho jaye, extinct ho jaye, to kya hoga, what happens if deer is going to extinct, then the quantity of grass is going to increase, kyunki deer kya eat karte hain, grass. Us particular ecosystem mein kya hoga, jo grass hai uski quantity kya ho jayegi, zyada. And the wolf, they are not, unka kya hoga, wolf ko khana nahi milega. They can eat deer, they can eat as well as rabbit. तो देख क्या eat करेंगे वो, rabbit. The population of rabbit is also going to decrease because now wolf they are going to eat rabbit. Similarly with lion, अभी तो वो deer भी खा लेते थे lion, लेकिन अभी क्या होगा, क्योंकि deer है ही नहीं वहाँ पे उस ecosystem में particular, तो अब क्या होगा, वो भी rabbit को ज़्यादा eat करेंगे और wolf को ज़्यादा eat करेंगे. So इनकी population क्या हो जाएगी, कम. और लायन की पॉपुलेशन क्या हो जाएगी, ज़्यादा. सो द होल इकोसिस्टम इज इम्बैलेंस्ड ड्यू टू, अगर एक भी एनिमल इसमें से जो ऑर्गेनिज्म है वो इस जो फूड चेन है, फूड वेब है, उसमें से मिसिंग होता है तो पूरी जो फूड चेन है, पूरा जो इकोसिस्टम है वो इफेक्ट होता है. दैट्स वाई इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू सेव each and every member of ecosystem. So each and every component of ecosystem is equally important. If we talk about temperature, we talk about rain, we talk about the quality of soil, everything is equally important. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि ये कम हो गया है तो इसकी वजह से बाकी ecosystem को कोई effect नहीं होगा, ऐसा नहीं होता है. The whole ecosystem gets affected by a slight minor change in any of the organism or any of the environmental factor. So it is very important. That's why all the things are interconnected. कहा जाता है ना कि pollution नहीं होना चाहिए ज़्यादा, water pollution नहीं होना चाहिए, और animals को save करो, conservation of biodiversity. So all these things are important to protect the ecosystem. So now what is this biodiversity? Biodiversity means variety of flora and fauna in a particular place. That is known as biodiversity. You know, the thousand of species of animals and thousand of species of plants are present in this earth. So millions, even not thousand, millions of species can be present. So that is the variety of flora and fauna. If you go to desert, to wahan pe kya hogi, species kam hogi, variety kam hogi. If you go to desert ecosystem, if you go to evergreen forest, to wahan kya hoga, wahan pe bahut zyada variety hogi, plants ki bhi aur animals ki bhi. So that is biodiversity. And biodiversity is, conservation of biodiversity means preservation of all these animals and plants in their natural habitat. That is known as conservation of biodiversity. जिस environment में या जिस ecosystem में वो रहते हैं, हम ecosystem को as it is क्या करें, conserve करें. That is known as conservation of biodiversity. Now government has set up various biosphere reserves, national park and sanctuaries for preservation of these biodiversity. You can see your book, this biosphere reserve, these are multi-purpose protected areas meant for conservation of representative wildlife. In India there are 18 biosphere reserves. National park, these are area for protection of wildlife maintained by government where cultivation and hunting is not allowed. In India there are 115 national parks. Sorry, if we talk about sanctuaries, protected natural habitats where hunting is not allowed, but other activities are allowed. So in India there are 515 sanctuaries. This you can read from your book. Now we have three type of animals: endangered, extinct and endemic. Now what do you mean by extinct? The animals which are now not living, in past, in future these animals are alive, but now their species have extinct. They no longer exist on the earth. These are known as extinct animals. Example, dodo, American lion, passenger pigeon. These are few example of extinct animals. Then we have endangered animals. Endangered means these animals are still alive, but in future their species can extinct because their number are reducing on very fast rate. So these are very few animals of these species are left on the earth. So these are endangered species. Example, Asian elephant, black rhino and blue whale. These are few endangered animals. That means we have to work hard to protect these animals. Then endemic animals. Endemic animals, these animals are only found in special places only. And that is the duty of that nation. जिस भी country में ये animal मिलते हैं उस country की क्या होती है, ये उनकी, it is their duty to protect these endemic animals. क्योंकि ये animals, इनकी species सिर्फ उस specific country या उस specific area में ही मिलती है. तो उस country का क्या होता है, उसका ये फर्ज है, that is their responsibility to save these endemic animals. For example, in India, lion-tailed macaw and Asiatic lion. These are only found in India. So it's the responsibility of India to save these animals. So this chapter is over now. Please complete your home assignment. Thank you.